Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today this is the first video regarding class 10th chemistry, and this is the first chapter, first topic, reversible reaction and dynamic equilibrium. जैसे कि स्टूडेंट्स आपने देखा होगा, हमारे यहाँ हम आम अपने सराउंडिंग्स में भी देखते हैं बहुत सारे ऐसी प्रोसेसेस हो रहे हैं, नेचुरल फिनोमेना ऐसे हैं जिसमें एक प्रोसेस हो रहा होता है लेकिन वो वापस भी उसी तरह से काउंटर बैलेंस हो रहा होता है. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ गैसेस, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड ऑक्सीजन. एक तरफ प्लांट्स आर मेकिंग देयर फूड बाय यूजिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस, बट ऑन द अदर हैंड थ्रू रेस्पिरेशन दे आर एक्सक्रीटिंग आउट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. सो कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड ऑक्सीजन रिमेन्स ऑलमोस्ट सेम इन द एनवायरमेंट. But when we talk about chemistry, there are certain reactions which are irreversible and some are reversible. Irreversible reactions are those which are supposed to complete, they proceed in only one direction. Yani wo reactions jo sirf ek direction mein complete ho jate hain, and when the reactants are combined together to make new substance that is called product, and this product is not decomposed back into the reactants, this process is called irreversible reaction. For example, if we have hydrogen gas and iodine vapors, we heat it, hydrogen iodide is formed. Hydrogen gas is colorless gas. Iodine vapors are purple brown in color. But by the end of the reaction, we get colorless vapors, colorless gas. That confirms that new substance has been formed. But there are certain reactions when conditions are provided, the product is converted back into the reactants. First, we have to know about the reactant and product. Those substances which are combined together to make new substance, they are called reactants. So, in this reaction, these are reactants. And hydrogen iodide is a product. And the irreversible reaction is always shown by a single arrow. But if we have in a reversible reaction, a reaction in which reactants are converted into products, but after some time products are converted back into the reactants, and we cannot attain the final end product of any of the substance, such reactions are called reversible reactions. वो reactions जिनमें reactants in the beginning products में change होते हैं, लेकिन कुछ time के बाद products are decomposed back into the reactants, और ये इसी तरह मुसलसल होता रहता है, और हमारे पास जो final result होता है उसमें ना तो completely reactants products में change हुए होते हैं और ना ही completely products reactants में change हुए होते हैं. So we can have either of the component in its specific concentration in the reaction mixture. सारे के सारे reactants और products सारे के सारे एक specific अपनी concentration के साथ उस reaction mixture में मौजूद होते हैं. A reversible reaction, we can take the example of reversible reaction from the above reaction. For example, first we took hydrogen gas and iodine vapors, it was converted into hydrogen iodide. If we have hydrogen iodide in a closed flask and we heat it, it will be changed into hydrogen gas and purple vapors will be seen. It means that iodine vapors have been formed back. So we can summarize this reaction into one reaction this reaction and this reaction into one reaction. We can write it down like H2 plus I2 . This is showing that hydrogen and iodine vapors are combined together to make hydrogen iodide vapors. But after a certain period of time, hydrogen iodide has been decomposed back into hydrogen gas and iodine vapors. So this sign is basically showing that this is the reversible reaction. Here, first the reactants were converted into products, and in the beginning reaction was fast. Reactants were readily converted into products, but after some time the forward reaction, this is forward reaction above one, forward reaction is always shown by a single headed arrow, and the reverse reaction, it is always shown by a single headed arrow which is in the opposite direction. So this is a reversible reaction, which is showing that first hydrogen gas and iodine vapors were converted into hydrogen iodide gas, and ultimately after some time the product is converted back into the reactants. There would be a time when rate of forward reaction, this is this one, becomes equal to rate of reverse reaction, that is this one, means the extent, the speed at which reactants are converted into the products at the same time, with the same speed and extent, products are converted back into the reactants. So we call this condition as equilibrium. ये बिल्कुल ऐसे जैसे मैं आपसे कहूँ कि मैं दो steps आगे चलूँ, फिर दो steps पीछे, फिर दो steps आगे, फिर दो steps पीछे. The net result is no change in the position. Same is the case with the reaction. There is certain time when rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of reverse reaction. So reaction is occurring. It's not being stopped. But the net result of the concentration of the reactants and products is same. It means that either of the substance is present in the reaction mixture in the specific concentration. So, एक reversible reaction जब होता है, उसमें rate of forward reaction in the beginning is higher, but after some time, rate of reverse reaction becomes higher, means कि प्रोडक्ट्स तेजी से रिएक्टेंट में चेंज होने शुरू हो जाते हैं, लेकिन एक वक्त आता है जब रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन बिकम्स इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ रिवर्स रिएक्शन एंड देयर इज नो नेट चेंज इन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स. दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड इक्विलिब्रियम. इक्विलिब्रियम इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स. वन इज स्टैटिक इक्विलिब्रियम. And the other is dynamic. Static, उसके नाम से ही पता चल रहा है, जिसमें reaction stop हो जाता है. Normally, we can observe static equilibrium in physical phenomena. For example, हम कहते हैं कि एक building मुसलसल खड़ी है, उस पर जितनी भी forces act कर रही हैं, they are canceling out each other. So as a result of that cancellation, वो building हमें सामने खड़ी नजर आती. But dynamic equilibrium is observed in mostly in those phenomena where liquid or gases are involved. For example, we have discussed the above reaction. इसमें आपने देखा पहले reactants convert हुए product में, फिर products decompose back हुए reactants में. और एक पोजिशन, एक वक्त ऐसा आया कि जब रिएक्टेंट्स रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन बिकेम इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ रिवर्स रिएक्शन एंड द फाइनल सिचुएशन इज दिस दैट देयर इज नो नेट चेंज इन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट एंड product. This is called dynamic equilibrium, because reaction is continuously occurring, but there is no change in the concentration. This is called dynamic equilibrium. Dynamic equilibrium is attained when specific conditions of temperature and pressure are applied, and when there is a change in temperature and pressure, we can change the position of concentrations of reactants and products. Again, reaction forwardly move karega, backwardly move karega, and ultimately we will attain the equilibrium. Hopefully you got this. Inshallah, in the next class we will discuss about the macroscopic characteristics of forward and reverse reaction, and macroscopic characteristics of dynamic equilibrium. If you feel any problem, you can drop the question in the comment box. See you in the next video, inshallah.